So when we consider the basic structure of SQL, how to write the basic structure? See, DDL DML is different. DDL is the part of data definition language. DML is the data manipulation language that we are going to see afterwards. In between, we are going to see the basic structure of SQL, that the queries which are used to retrieve the data. DDL is used to define the database. We define the tables, schemas, the domain types, etc. Integrity constraint, we can alter, we can do all these things with DDL. In DML, we are going to manipulate, insert, update, and delete. But how to retrieve the data from the tables or the relations where the data is stored? And that is comes under the basic structure of SQL. So basic structure of SQL, when we consider, okay, so when we consider the basic structure of SQL, select, from, and where, these are the three clauses we use to write the basic query of SQL. So the first one is select clause. So select, here we select or write those attributes we want in the result. Okay, we wish to appear in the result, that attributes we write here. So A1, A2 to AN, AM, the number of attributes that we wish to appear in the result. Select from. So from, we are going to retrieve these attributes from some relations. So in the from clause, we write the name of the relations R1, R2 to RK, where predicate P is true. Only select those tuples where the predicate P is true. That is the basic structure of SQL query, select, from, and where. Now see, this select, from, and where, in these A1, A2 to AM, these are the set of attributes that we wish to appear in the result. R1, R2 to RK is the relations which we are going to evaluate. On the that relations, we are going to evaluate the query. And P is the predicate. Okay? That indicates if that predicate is true, that tuple is only selected from that relation. And those attributes are only displayed in the result. So the simple basic query or structure of SQL query is select, from, and where clause, where AI represent the attributes, RI represent the relation, and P is a predicate. P is the predicate. Next, so the result of SQL query is always a relation. The result of SQL query is always a relation, resulting relation, we call it as a. The select clause, it is used to list the attribute desired in the result of a query. From clause is a list of relations to be assessed during the evaluation of the query. And the where clause is a predicate for tuples, or it select only those tuples where the predicate P is true. Now, if we consider this select, from, and where, it is equivalent to relational algebra operations. This select, from, and where, these are equivalent to relational algebra operation. Then which operations it is equivalent? That is the question. So when we consider the equivalence it with the relational algebra operation, select is equivalent to the project operation of relational algebra, which is denoted by uppercase Greek letter phi. Then, so here project A1, A2 to AM, same query, how we write it in the relational algebra. Then from is the, if there is a single relation, then no issue. But if there are multiple relation, more than two relation, two or more relation, then it is equal to the Cartesian product of relational algebra. And where it is a predicate. So where we apply the predicate in relational algebra? In select operation. So it is equal to the, or equivalent to the selection operation, which is denoted by this lowercase Greek letter sigma. So when we write this query, same query in relational algebra, how we write? Project A1, A2 to AM, select the predicate is P from relations R1, R2 to RK in this way. So how this relational algebra query? It first make the Cartesian product of R1, R2 to RK, then select only those tuples where predicate P is true, and then from that project only these attributes. So in this way, same way this query execute. It first make the Cartesian product of R1, R2 to RK, then select only those tuples where the predicate P is true, and then from that project these attributes in the result. So whenever such kind of question is there, it is easy to convert SQL into the relational algebra or relational algebra to the SQL, or it may be possible such type of question may be there in the exam, that we have given four queries and ask you to convert from relational algebra to SQL or from SQL to relational algebra. Okay, so that is about the structure of SQL query. Now with example we are going to see all these different examples we are going to see for it. So select class, first we are going to see the queries on single relation. Okay, only R is there, that first we are going to see some examples, and after that we will see the examples with multiple relations. Single relation first example, the select clause, as I already told, list the attribute desired in the result of a query. It is correspond to the projection operation of relational algebra. Now the query is find the name of all instructors. What we wish to appear in the result? Name of the instructor. So for this, which relation is required here to evaluate the query? Which relation is required here to evaluate the query? Instructor relation. Okay? So instructor relation, from that we want the name of the instructor. So simply I write select name. Okay, we need to write the attribute name as we created in the table, the same name. So select name from instructor. Is there any predicate given here? No predicate is given there, and that's why where clause is optional. Not necessary that each and every query you need to write the where clause. If there is any condition or predicate, then only apply the where clause, or then only we need to write the where clause. Now in this example, there is not required to write the where clause, as there is no predicate or no condition is there. Only we want the name of all instructors. So the result of query is like this. Name of the instructors from the instructor relation. Now see another example. Find the department name of all instructors. Now what is required in the result of the query? Which attribute? Department name. Which relation we required here to execute this query? Instructor again. So the simple query is here, select department name from instructor. Again, no condition is given there, no predicate is given there, and that's why not necessary to write the where clause. Select department name from instructor, and these are the department name. Now what we observe this result here, we observe that in this result duplications are there. Computer science, you can see three times computer science is there. Okay, whatever, there are instructors, three instructors with the computer science, they need to appear three times. If there are 10 instructors of computer science will appear 10 times in the result. Similarly, physics you can see appear two times, finance is there, history is there, means multiple times, so duplications are there. Why it happens? Because the SQL not remove the duplications automatically. SQL keep the duplication as it is. SQL keep the duplication as it is, not remove the duplications automatically. Now how to remove the duplicates? Department name, they appear so many times. So how to remove the duplicates? And for that, in SQL, distinct keyword is used. In SQL, distinct keyword is used. So same query, how we write? Select distinct department name from instructor. So here the word keyword, extra keyword is used, that is distinct. So once I use this keyword, what happens? The department name appears only once. That particular department name appears only once. So the computer science, history, finance, it appears only once. And if you want to keep all these, you can use the simple, or along with that, all keyword is given here to specify that not remove the duplicates, keep the duplicate. But it is not necessary to use, because without distinct also it keep the duplicates, but that keyword is available. That is about the simple queries with or without where clause. Now suppose I want to convert this query, previous query, okay, select name from instructor, I want to write it in relational algebra. I want to write it in relational algebra. How to write the query in relational algebra? Select name from instructor. Project, sorry. Project name from instructor. In parenthesis, after this we write the name of the relation. So the result of both the query is same. Similarly, in the next, the department name is there only. So if I want to write it in the relational algebra, again project department name from instructor. The result of both the queries same. Here the result of both the queries same. To eliminate duplicates, we use distinct. Now the next example, an asterisk is used here, an asterisk symbol, star symbol is used here to denote the all attributes. Suppose I write the query select star from instructor. So it retrieves the entire instructor table or the relation as it is. It displays the entire instructor relation as it is in the result. ID, name, department name, salary, all the tuples, whatever the rows are there, all are displayed. So asterisk symbol, it is used to select all attributes, entire relation as it is. Next. So here we observe that along with this, in select we can use the simple operations, mathematical operation, arithmetic operation, such as plus, minus, multiplication and division. Plus, minus, multiplication and division, these operation we can use in the select. So one example is given here, ID, name, department name retrieved here, select ID, name, department, salary is multiplied with 1.1. 1.1 means increase by 10%. Salary is increased or display increasing 10%. Means what is the result of this query? In this way, ID, name, department name, salary, name of the attribute is same, salary, ID suppose 10101, Einstein, department name physics. Now if his salary is 80,000, okay, original salary is 80,000, then it is increased by 10% and it displays here in the result 88,000. But this value is not stored in the database. It is only purpose to display, not stored in the database. It not manipulate the information, it not update the salary. Select only display the information. So it is only the purpose of display. If I want to display the salary with 10% rise, then it gives the result. Only display purpose, but not stored in the database. Suppose this is the annual salary and I want to display the monthly salary. Then here I can write instead of this salary divided by 12. So here it shows the monthly salary of that instructor, but not stored in the database. The values in the database are not updated, only display purpose it is. So that is about the arithmetic operation that we can use here in the select operation or along with the select operation select clause. Now we are going to see some examples with where clause. So the where clause allows us to select only those tuples that must satisfy a specified predicate. Whatever the condition is given there, if that condition is satisfied, then only that tuple is displayed in the result. It is corresponding to the selection operation of relational algebra, that is lowercase Greek letter sigma. So the query is that, or the statement is that, to find all instructors in the computer science department with salary 70,000. With salary 70,000. So such type of statement is there. Read it again and try to find out. The first thing is we need to identify the relation on which it operates. Second, the predicate if there any, and the attributes to appear in the result. So that three things we need to identify. So I read it again. Find all instructors in the computer science with salary 70,000. So here the required relation is again instructor. Why? Because instructor name is there, salary is there, department is there, all in the instructor relation. So single instructor relation is sufficient. What predicate is given here? Department name is computer science and salary greater than 70,000, means two predicates are given here. Two predicates are given here, and in the result we want name of the instructors. So here I write the query for this statement. Select what we want in the result: name from instructor. Now two predicates are given here, so in where clause we need to write two predicate. What is the first predicate? Department name is equal to computer science. Again, SQL is case sensitive. So department name, whatever while you create the table, the attribute name you have to give in the same way. Here in the computer science, in single quote, computer space science, again case sensitive. The computer science, how you have written or insert the value in your table, in the same way you have to write it here. Computer science. Now second predicate is there, salary greater than 70,000. Now how to connect these two predicates? In relational algebra we use and, or, and not. So here instead of that, the logical operator and is used. Here we use mathematical operators in relational algebra. In SQL we use logical operators and, or, and not. So and salary greater than 70,000. So it, how this query execute? This query first find out those tuples where department name is equal to computer science and salary greater than 70,000, and from that display only the name from the instructor relation. So in this way the simple query execute. Okay, and the result, name of the instructors where computer science, three instructors are there, correct, but only two are displayed here. Why? Because the salary condition, those who are greater than 70,000, that only displayed here. One instructor is below 70,000, that is not displayed here. And operation is there, means both the conditions should be satisfied. Now suppose I want to write this in relational algebra, how I can write it? So we want in the result, or we wish to appear in the result, name of the instructor, what predicate is given here? Two predicates are there, so sigma department name is equal to computer science, and here I use this connectivity, and salary greater than 70,000. Okay, from in bracket or in parenthesis, the name of the relation on which we operate the these two operations. So the result of both these same. So in this way, any relational algebra query you can convert it into the SQL, or any SQL query you can convert it into the relational algebra, as both are compatible with each other, both languages. Now see the next example. So here the comparison result or multiple predicate are there, then we use logical connectivities and or not, and comparison we use all the comparison operators plus less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, not equal to, and equal to. These six comparison operators we can use in the predicate. Next. Okay, so SQL provides between comparison operators. So before that, I'm going to give you the example first. I will explain. Suppose there is one statement: find the name of all instructors with salary between 90,000 and 1 lakh. If it is there, salary between 90,000 and 1 lakh, then in that case, how we write the query? Simple query. Select what we want in the result. Name. Only one instructor relation is sufficient, because name of the instructors are there, salaries are there, so it is sufficient. So select name from instructor where salary 90,000 to 1,000. So I can write here salary greater than or equal to 90,000 and salary less than or equal to 1 lakh. Okay, in this way I can write, but SQL provide the between clause for such kind of comparisons. If it is the value between some constant values, then we can use between operator here. Between comparison operator is provided by SQL. So the same query, how we can write in SQL using between. So the simple statement is that salary between 90,000 and 1 lakh. Instead of using two different predicates, we can directly use between. Now see, the SQL allows the tuple comparison. So in this way we can again I'm going to explain it. Here two relations are there. Only remember that SQL allows the tuple comparison, means instructor.id and department name we can compare in this way. So it compared instructor.id with teachers.id and department name with biology. So it select the name and course ID of those instructors where department name is biology. So in this way it allows the comparison between, or tuple comparison is directly allowed in SQL. Okay, now we move towards the multiple relation. Up to this we have seen the queries on single relation. Now we are going to see the queries on multiple relations. Okay, so the from clause here, up to this there is a single relation, but if in the from clause there is a list of relations, two or more relation, then it is equal to or the correspond to the Cartesian product of relational algebra. For example, see, suppose I write here, select star from instructor comma teaches. So what it perform? It perform simple Cartesian product of teaches and instructor, and this is the result. Means what it perform? Every tuple of instructor it attach with every other tuple of teaches. In this way, every tuple of instructor it attach with every other tuple of teaches. So if there are n1 tuples in the instructor and n2 tuples in the teachers, then in the resulting relation there are n1 into n2 tuples. Means if there are 12 tuples and here are 15 tuples, then here 180 tuples in the result. But there is one drawback. What is the drawback of Cartesian product? No. In most of the tuples, we observe that instructor.id is not equal to teachers.id. And that's why while we retrieve the data from this Cartesian product result, it gives the wrong result. When we retrieve the data from this Cartesian product, it gives the wrong result. Why? Because in most of the tuples, instructor.id is not equal to teachers.id. You can observe here. Only in these three tuples, instructor.id is equal to teachers.id. Remaining all tuples, it is not the case. And because of this, when we retrieve the information from the Cartesian product of two relations, it gives the wrong result. And how to avoid it? Natural join, or how we need to force selection or forcing equality on those attributes which are common in both the relation. What we need to add here? We need to add here predicate where instructor.id is equal to teachers.id. We need to apply here one more predicate where instructor.id is equal to teachers.id. In Cartesian product, we write there select instructor.id is equal to teachers.id. Correct? We add one more predicate. In the same way, here we need to add one more predicate for such kind of result or to avoid the wrong results. So the same one, how we write? Select star from instructor comma teaches. Instructor comma teaches. Here what we need to add? One more predicate. Where we add it in? Where clause. So where instructor dot id is equal to teaches dot id. Means how this query execute? It first make the Cartesian product of instructor into teacher. Then from that select only those tuples where instructor.id is equal to teachers.id and display the result. As star is there, all the attributes are displayed. Okay, in this way. Only display those tuples where instructor.id is equal to teachers.id. So some examples we are going to see, then all the concept you will clear about this. So when we solve this query, first we need to identify which attributes we wish to appear in the result. In the result we wish to appear name and course ID. That's why we require two relations, that is instructor and teachers. Why? In the instructor and teachers, name is there and the relation between that, so course ID is required. So two relations are required. So the simple query is select name comma course ID from instructor comma teachers, where as there is no other predicate is given, but two relations are there, and in that two relation the common attribute is ID. So instructor dot ID is equal to teaches.id. Then it gives a required result in this way. The name of the instructor and the course ID taught by that instructor. Now suppose here the same query, see, find the instructor name and course IDs identifiers for the instructors in the computer science department. Same query, what is added here? One more predicate is added, that is department name is equal to computer science. So department name is available in the instructor, so not necessary to use any other. Instructor and teacher, both are sufficient. So the query is select name course ID from the instructor comma teacher, where instructor dot ID is equal to teachers dot ID, and here we add one more predicate, that department name is equal to computer science. So it only displays those tuples where department name is equal to computer science. Now the next example, retrieve the name of the instructors, all instructors along with their department names and building name. Retrieve, read again, retrieve the name of all instructors along with their department names and department building name. So the query is select name department name building, correct, from instructor comma department, where instructor dot department name is equal to department name dot department name. Now see, in the select clause there is a department name, okay, in the select clause name comma department name. From which two relations we take this value? From the instructor and department. Now in both the relation instructor and department there is a department name, correct? So how SQL understood from where to retrieve the department name? Have you got my question? See, the department name I write here from instructor comma department, okay. Now department name appears in both the relation. Department name appears in both the relation. Now how the SQL understood from where to retrieve the department name, from where, instructor or from the department? So what is your understanding, where it should be, from instructor or department? Instructor. Why? Because we are finding the name and instructor's department along with their building, correct? Means we want the instructor's department, so this department should be from the instructor relation. Now how the SQL understood it? For that we need to write here instructor dot department name, instructor dot department name. Have you got? If here in the result we want to display such an attribute which appear in both the relation, then we need to use prefix, the name of that relation from where it is to be retrieved. So here department name is appear in both the relation, so we need to use here the prefix instructor dot department name. So the query is like this, select name instructor dot department name building from instructor comma department, where instructor dot department name is equal to department dot department name. The SQL is a non-procedural language, so here we must need to explain what procedure is there. So need to explain here from where to take the department name, okay. So in this way, name, department name and the building. Srinivasan is from computer science, and where it is located, the building, the Taylor. Next example, find the course ID, semester, year, title of each course offered by computer science department. फाइंड द कोर्स आईडी, सेमिस्टर, ईयर एंड टाइटल ऑफ ईच कोर्स ऑफर्ड बाय कंप्यूटर साइंस डिपार्टमेंट. So first we need to identify which attributes we wish to appear in the result. So in the result we wish to appear the course ID, semester, year and title of the course. And title of the course. So I write here initially select course ID, semester. So these are some attributes we wish to appear in the result and title of the course. So which relations we need to use here on which this query evaluate? First we need that title is available in the course only. Okay, what are the attributes of course? Course ID, title and the credits. So title is available in the course only, so course is required. Along with that, semester, year and the course ID also we require. So which relation, second relation is required here? Section, correct. Section comma course. And which attribute is common in between these two? Course ID is common. So where section dot course ID is equal to course dot course ID. Another predicate is also given here. What is that? Department name is equal to computer. In the course, department name is available. So not necessary to use any other relation. In the course, department name is there. ID, title, department name and credits. These four attributes are there in the course. Now, course ID. Again, it is a common between both the relations. So here we need to use the prefix section dot course ID. From that we take the semester and year. Correct? Course ID for that semester and year. So that is available in the section. So the query is like this. Now here in short, how the SQL query works. In general, the meaning of SQL query can be understood as follows. Generate a Cartesian product of the relation listed in the from clause. Okay. Generate the Cartesian product of the relation which are listed in the from clause. Apply the predicate and select only those tuples which satisfy that predicate from this result, and then from this select only those attributes that we wish to appear in the result. In this way the SQL query execute. First it forms the Cartesian product of this list, whatever the relation listed. Then select only those tuples where the predicate P is true, and from that select only those or display only those attributes that are here in the select clause or we wish to appear in the result. That is about the general statement about the SQL query.